Hello guys and welcome back to my channel, Cecilia here. So today I would like to just get straight to the point and talk about my German culture shock as a Kenyan. So let us get into this. The first thing that really shocked me, guys, was how people count in Germany, because it is 1, 2, 3. Yes. When someone is counting and they start doing this, it's all right, 1, 2, 3. But when they're only talking about one thing and they say, "I only had one mango," it's still very funny to me. I'm sorry, but it's funny to me, because this to me is saying we are good. It's all right, but it's not like one. I don't know. So I still count like this, 1, 2, 3. That is what comes naturally to me. But if I'm talking to a German and I want them to understand me, of course I'll do this and then it's good. But that was one of the culture shocks. I know they're silly things, but they're things that I wasn't used to, but I am getting used to after 9 years now in Germany. So let's get to the second one. When I traveled, the first time I traveled to Turkey and we landed in Turkey, people clapped. I was like, the plane just landed and everybody was like, that for me was a culture shock, because I had never seen that. I know it's actually, I find it good actually that people clap when they land, because hey, I'm happy to arrive where I was going. But that I wasn't expecting that. I was just, it caught me by surprise. I was not used to this in Kenya, but when you get in a train or on a bus, people always tend to go to that seat where nobody is sitting. Like people go to the farthest corner to be alone, just not to sit near someone else. So you will find like there is seats, four seats, and there's one person here, one person here, one person there, like that. Yeah, they are scattered all over, just not to sit next to anybody else. So I wasn't used to that in Kenya. In Kenya you find people go exactly where everybody else is to make space for the next people who are coming. Different, yeah, but it was a culture shock for me, and I tend to do that now. I do not know why, but every time I sit, I'm looking for this next empty space where nobody is. So I adapted that very fast. I am not proud of that, but another culture shock is that people are happy to follow rules and regulations. coming from Kenya, I know we do this also, right, Kenyans? But people are just happy to do it. Like, people are happy to wait at the red light even if nobody is crossing the road and nobody is even on site. Someone will stand at the red light with their car for an hour. No, sorry, it doesn't go that long, but they'll stay as long as it is, even if it's at 3 a.m. in the morning and nobody is walking along the streets. So I find it good that people can follow rules and regulations. I'm not saying this is bad, but it was a culture shock for me, because the people have to follow rules, but Germans are happy to. They really enjoy following rules and regulations, and I find that really, really good. Another German culture shock was that there is receipts and stamps for everything. Like, it does not matter if it's just a letter you sent or somewhere you parked, or I don't know, there's a receipt and a stamp for everything. It's a receipt and stamp culture. So that was a lot for me, because there is a lot of paperwork in Germany. Like, oh my god, even just leave school, just being here for the first year, I was actually a au pair girl. That means like an exchange student babysitter kind of a thing, and I stayed for 1 year. The only thing I did, I only got out to go to German classes, and you cannot believe the kind of paperwork I had just for being here 1 year only in Germany. So everything has, there's a lot of paperwork here, and everything has a stamp or a receipt, or receipts and stamps, all of them together, a lot of paperwork. People don't know how to queue in Germany. Yeah, I know. Someone will come for me for this, but people do not know how to queue. So Germans are used to getting numbers. Like you go to a place and you get a number, and then you know which number you are. And then you know how to follow with the numbers. But just queuing, like a straight, nice queue, Germans don't know how to do that. And then something else I notice is that people do not talk to each other when they're queuing. Like there's no chit chat or, I have seen very many queues in Kenya because a lot of many times at the bank or somewhere you'll have to queue and for a long time. But people start small talks and chit chat to pass the time as they're queuing. I do not see that in Germany. So that was also a culture shock for me. I tried to start a few small talks while queuing and nobody responded, so I got used to it. Now I'm on my phone like anyone else. Something else I really like actually is when people are talking about something that they wish would happen to them, or they hope it wouldn't happen to them, as to scare the bad intentions, the bad spirits away. They knock on wood. So I know people say knock on wood, or other cultures say that too. But I didn't know that. Maybe it's just me, but I did not know that as I lived in Kenya. And when I came to Germany and I saw people knocking on wood, like I hope I don't get sick. Knock on wood. Everybody's getting sick, but I hope I wouldn't. Like something like that. So they knock on wood a lot. Of course not everybody, but it was new to me. Yeah. Something else, guys, is these small gestures that people do. Like sometimes they won't talk much. They just be like, and someone is just in the middle of a sentence, and then they're saying something like, and he expected me to go and visit him. And you're like, what was that? Like this meant like, am I crazy or what? So there are a few gestures that I find funny, but only if you live in Germany or you know a few Germans, you will understand the language. But a lot of hand gestures that I did not expect. So let me know if you know more, because I know that I know more, but I have forgotten them. If you live in Germany or you are German, so please be very, very kind to me and write what you think other people would find as a culture shock when they come to Germany. I would like to know. A lot of shops and companies and offices close on Mondays. Yeah, they call it Ruhetag, and it's not every shop, it's not everybody, but it is not a surprise that you go to a shop and it's closed on Monday because they're taking a break on Monday. So on the weekend they did not work. Like on Sunday everything is closed except for a few things. On holidays everything is closed, and then on Monday people take offs or just close the shop break, and they write Ruhetag. Ruhetag means just it's an off day. And it is understood. That was a big shock for me because I come from Kenya, and first of all, a lot of things happen on a daily basis in Kenya. I can go to the bank and go and buy groceries and go shopping on a Sunday in Kenya. Very, very possible. And that was something I was used to. And then I came here, I could understand that Sundays and Saturdays some things are closed, but Monday was a big culture shock for me. So because you expect that Monday is when everything resumes to work, and if something you put off for the whole weekend, you expect to do it on Monday. Be sure in Germany it's not every day that we find every shop opened on Monday. There are shops that actually just take an off. These two were negative culture shocks for me. One of them was there is a lot of pornographic materials on regular TV. That was a big shock for me because mostly in Kenya we have adverts for condoms or even for sanitary pads, or we have all that, but most things come most things that are too pornographic, they come midnight when the kids are sleeping, or after 9 or after 10. And that is why most of us, when we were younger, we were not allowed to watch TV after 9, because there would be a lot of adverts and a lot of pornographic material that is not suitable for kids. So when you come to Germany, beware of this, that it is possible that your kids will see a naked model or something very pornographic on regular TV at noon or at 6 p.m. in the evening. It's very common. It's very expected, not expected, but it is normal in Germany to have such material on normal TV. So beware when you have kids here in Germany. Something else I really found shocking to me, which is also negative, sorry to say, is that smoking is tolerated at a very young age. That I have seen kids who are 14 and 15 and are smoking on the streets. Like, I know that there are kids that smoke all over the world, but for it to be tolerated at that level on the streets and nobody saying anything to these kids was a very big culture shock for me, because it's like, it's not my kid, I don't know, like, it's not taken so seriously. So that was a big shock for me. Because in Kenya, someone is marking you, I'm telling you, or someone is saying something. If you're 15 or 14 and you are lighting a cigarette at the bus station or something. So those are my two negative German culture shocks. All the others are just fun stuff that I like to notice between cultures. You guys know I travel a lot, so I will also tell you my culture shocks for other cultures or to places that I go so often to. So those are my German culture shocks. I hope you guys like them. Let me know what you think is not accurate. If you are German or you live in Germany and you think I've gotten something really wrong, let me know in the comment section below. I'll be happy to correct myself. Or let me know what your shocks were. I would really be happy to know them also. So thank you so much, guys, for watching today's video. Please subscribe. I have a lot in store for you for the next couple of months. So I hope you guys would subscribe and then follow me on Instagram and also on Facebook, Bucket List Says. And let us talk more about traveling and new experiences and items on our bucket list. So thank you so much, guys. I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.